Hi folks, it's Dr. P. This video is going to get you acquainted with the constant current source. So this is capable of creating exactly what the name implies, a constant current. This is opposed to the DC power supply, which creates a constant voltage. So just some information about how this thing works. There are two voltage regulators. This voltage regulator takes whatever is applied on our voltage input and essentially turns it into a constant voltage over a resistor. Because we have a constant voltage over a resistor, we have a constant current, which is then fed out through these two terminals. This is a voltage regulator that takes whatever voltage is applied here, as long as it's greater than 5 volts, and uses it to control the microcontroller, which enables the 7-segment display to give you a readout of how much current is flowing through this. So the first thing to note is you need to have at least 5 volts applied to this using the DC power supply. And because there are voltage regulators on here, you can really go ahead and crank this thing up. The higher the current that you want output on this, the higher the voltage is going to need to be here, where it might need to go as high as like 20, 25 volts in order to make this work. So this is going to be using more voltage than probably anything else that you've used. And there's going to be some power that dissipates through these voltage regulators. And if you notice, they are thermally pasted to and screwed to heat sinks. These are giant heat sinks, these big black things that have screws in the back. So I recommend not touching these, because you probably aren't going to burn yourself, but they can get quite hot. Okay, so just be careful with that. So these are built to just take regular banana plug connections, which I'm going to connect to the DC power supply. And I've got the DC power supply connected. It's turned up to just about 20, 22 volts right now. And what you notice when you first plug this thing in is that regardless of the setting of this potentiometer, which is used to control the current, this guy's going to read zero. And the reason it's reading zero is because there's no load connected to this at all. So what I recommend that you do as a calibration is to take these leads and plug them into the tabletop multimeter to get a current measurement and to just verify that this reading is kind of what you expect. So this uses an analog to digital converter over a couple of resistors in a voltage divider to essentially tell me what the current is. So the issue with that is that the resistors have some tolerance to them. The microcontroller uses integer-based logic and not floating-point logic. So this precision of the readout is not going to be perfect. I don't even show to the tenths place because that precision would kind of be false. So when you dial the potentiometer to a certain number, you can be assured that you're pretty close to that value, but you might not be exactly there. So when precision of what your actual current is counts, then you really ought to use the Fluke tabletop multimeter to get a current reading as you dial this. But again, as soon as you disconnect that load, the reading will go back to zero, and that's okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just apply this to a breadboard that I have hooked up that has just a resistor so that you can see what the readout looks like. Okay, so this is 19 milliamps. And then we can take a screwdriver and change the value of the current. And again, keep in mind that this is a constant current source. So the issue with a constant current source is going to be the higher the current, the less resistance we can have given a quarter watt resistor before the power rating is going to be maxed out. Okay, so if we're using like a 10K resistor, we need to be really careful that we're not creating so much current through there that the power rating is exceeded. So pretty much all of the resistors that we use are quarter watt. So using that quarter watt maximum, we can determine a relationship between the current that our constant current source is set to and the maximum resistor value that we can use. And that would be in a series arrangement. Okay, so if we have even two resistors in series that have that are greater than our max, right, that resistance, that current is constant, right? So it doesn't matter how many resistors we have in series, it's not going to drop the current. We're still going to have to worry about power ratings. We could put things in parallel to split the current up, right? It's a current divider, but anytime we have resistors that are just in one series path, we have to really be careful about what maximum values we use. So we just have to be a little bit cognizant of that. Otherwise, this is a relatively straightforward device to use. One thing I do want to note is that it is placed on an insulating base. So it can be removed from that insulating base. And if you look at the back, there are a bunch of solder points, and these screws create an electrical connection between the binding posts and the copper traces in the printed circuit board. So the reason that I have this placed in a piece of insulator is so that when you use this, you do not accidentally short out any of these leads. So if you were to short out these leads by pressing by putting this onto something metallic or accidentally having something like a screwdriver short over those leads, that could be a big problem, right? Because we have up to 20 volts or so applied on this side, and we have a constant current coming out of this side. So it's going to be important to make sure that they stay seated in the insulator backing. All right, folks, that's all about the constant current source. Until next time, stay well.